Welcome back. Welcome back to Forest School. Today we're going to see if we can make some bug houses. I'll show you how to turn this elder into this bug house. Let me show you why we use elder. It's because when you chop it, in the middle, there's a lovely soft bit of pith. And you can poke that out with a peg. So I've got my bit of elder here. I've taken the leaves off. I'm going to use my secateurs to snip the elder into short lengths. And you don't want to snip it anywhere near where the leaves join, because we won't be able to poke that on. So leave a little gap before the joins. Be very careful if you're using any tools. Make sure you've got an adult to help you. So there's my elder, cut to length and ready to use. If you wanted to get in a little bit of whittling practice and you've got an old potato peeler, you could use that to carefully peel off the bark to make it really nice and smooth underneath. Remember, always pushing away from your body. And wear a glove on your helper hand. When they're ready, what you need to do is see if you can hollow out some of the pith that's in the middle there. And I've got a palm drill that I can use. If you don't have a palm drill, you could always use a screwdriver. Be very careful that you don't poke your fingers. Just needs to go in about 2 or 3 centimetres, deep enough for a bug to climb into. Now, if you can't find an elder tree, ask your parents if they've got an old garden cane that you can use. And then using a mini hacksaw, you could carefully chop them up. Do the same. Gently poke out the pith in the middle, which will make a perfect house for a little bug to live in. But to make sure they're not sharp on the edges, otherwise you might need a bit of sandpaper to file it down, because the bugs won't like that on their wings. We're mainly going to be attracting bees into these, little mason bees. Some of them you can't poke through because they've got a hard end. Don't worry, you can leave that. So I'm going to put them all together now, all my bamboo and the elder that I made, and put the plastic band around just to keep them together while I find a piece of string. Actually, I think it needs a roof. What I've got here are some thicker bits of wood. This is some hazel wood that I found, and I'm going to put those on for my roof. I'm going to saw another bit of that. So I've got my thicker bits of wood acting as the roof over the top to give them some protection. Now I'm going to need some string to secure it. I'm going to use another piece of string to make a hanger. There we have the little bug house finished. I'm going to find a sunny spot in my garden and hang it there. Then I'm going to come back in a few weeks and see if I can see any bugs have moved into my house. Well, I hope you have fun making your own bug shelter. I'm off to hang mine up in a sunny spot in the garden, and then I think it's time for a hot chocolate. Remember, when you're using tools, always have an adult with you to help. And when you've finished at the end, you must always wash your hands. See you next time. Bye.